So the question you're asking is, when Jnana Yajna happens, the spiritual teaching happens, the beings in the different planes, will they participate? So that question comes to you because you had a vision that astral plane, many beings participate in Yajna, correct? That is true. There are 14 lokas, Bhuloka, Bhurloka, Suvarloka, Mahaloka, Janaloka, Tapoloka, Satyaloka. Now, any spiritual teaching which is very clear and which is speaking the truth is very rare. When that teaching happens, people from different planes participate in the teaching. That's why you must have heard when Ramayana is being told, Hanuman will come in some form. You've heard of that, right? Hanuman will come in from some form. That means wherever a teaching happens, those who have received the teaching will participate in some form. Anywhere Jnana Yajna happens, then Devatas means astral beings participate. Bhuloka, Bhurloka, Suvarloka, Mahaloka, Janaloka, higher level lokas, people participate. They participate in come listen. Because to get a clear clarity in Jnana is very difficult. So Jnana means even if somebody goes to Brahmaloka, for him the syllabus is same. Syllabus what you have to study in earth is same. Bhagavad Gita, Brahma Sutra, Upanishad. There's nothing else. If he has not completed, he'll go and study there. So then, to study purpose, if there's some teaching taking place, real good teaching taking place, those people participate. Those beings participate, astral beings participate. Rishis also participate. Right? Rishi doesn't not necessarily mean Jnani. Rishi means who is in this, maybe who has retained certain level of Jnana. So now, anywhere a Jnana Yajna takes place, beings from different planes participate. That's the rule. Depending on who is teaching Yajna. And there are so many Yajnas. There are different types of Yajnas. You offer something in food, something in this thing. Many types of Yajnas are possible. Right? The highest form of Yajna is called Brahma Yajna. The knowledge of Brahman is the highest form of Yajna. There's no Yajna which is equivalent to that. That means highest Yajna. You have heard of Soma Yaga, this Yaga, that Yaga, where material is offered. In Jnana Yajna, only ignorance is offered and it leads to Mukti. Brahma, this is called Brahma Yajna. Brahma Yajna is the highest form of Yajna. When highest form of Yajna is participated, definitely people, those who want to be interested, will participate. Okay? So now, the person who conducts the Yajna, he should be very evolved to conduct that Yajna because there should not be any mistakes in what he teaches. So that's why if Brahma Yajna is conducted, people from all the lokas will participate, provided he is a Jnani, Brahmanishta. For a Acharya or somebody, they may not participate because it's just a learning. Whereas a Jnani does a Brahma Yajna, beings from multiple planes participate. Does that answer your question? And Jnani is beyond all these planes. Bhuloka, Bhuvaloka, Suvarloka, Maharloka, Janaloka, Tapoloka. He has gone beyond that. That's why all Devatas and Rishis will respect the Jnani teaching. Whereas Acharya is in the lower plane, teacher. With that, we'll conclude today's session. We'll go for lunch. Hari Om.
Hari Om, Gurudev.